What's up, guys? Welcome to another Grub and Talk podcast. Hopefully, you're having a great day. How's everybody doing today?
Doing great.
As you guys can see, we're only three today. Somebody was on his way here and they couldn't make it. And they said, yo, we can't make it, so we're going to cancel on you guys. Flake Nation.
Yeah.
Everybody knows people like that, though. Like, that be flaking it and shit, and then they don't, like... They'll be like, yeah, I'm going to roll through, bro. Don't worry about it. I got you.
You know what I think is funny about that?
What funny
is
about that?
Is that... It's like, you know, those flaky people that you have or you know? You always invite them constantly. Like, hey, dude, we're doing this. You want to roll through, blah, blah. Every time, oh, yeah, I'm down. In the last minute, they always end up canceling. And then when you invite them again, you actually stop inviting them because you know they're not going to come through because they're always flaking it on you.
And they get all mad.
You don't hit them up. It's like, bro, what the hell? Like, I hit you up so many times. You flaked this, so why even bother?
It's like those people, like they say, you know, in Spanish, they say, no, for all my Spanish-speaking people, no soy monedita de oro, para que le vien a todos. Like, you're not always,
yeah,
you know,
true,
you're not sure. Always, and not everybody's going to like you. Everybody's going to find an excuse to like you or not like you and shit.
Yeah, dude, for sure. I think I was always, like, with my homies, like, even... Well, not no more, but
before,
I would always like, I would always be the try hard, like really try to be a good friend. But like now it's just I only do like, I don't go above and beyond for people, but it's just like, you know, if you got me, I got you. And I put as much effort as you give me, you know, and I got to the point like that because like, it got to the point where you feel like your time, or it isn't even your time, it's just like the things you do for them, it's they don't value it, and then it just becomes like they're an expectance, like they expect you to go to those lengths for them and nothing to be in there return too. Like, yeah,
fake,
yeah.
Ass homies, dog.
Nah, I think those are not no, well, yeah, you like, can say they're fake too.
You got some like fake ass homies, like
they take advantage of you.
Yeah.
Well,
It's crazy because we all like grown ass adults and we're talking about that shit, but it's true though, because there's a lot of those people that are fucking cancerous. They're
and a lot of snakes too, bro.
Toxic as hell. You know, they say they got you, blah, blah, blah. Ride or die. And like at the end when it counts, like they ain't there. And like, and it's funny because the homies that are all hype and shit like that, that they're, oh yeah, it's cool to do this, cool to do that, cool to do that. They're always there.
They're there
for like the cool shit. But when it really counts, when it really matters, those fools, you can't even see this. You can't even see the sun, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Nah, but I have a homie. Well, we all have like best friends and shit like that. But I like my homie Rigo. The other day we were driving, and then we get to his goddamn, bro.
Jesus Christ, my bad.
They're fucking from Renner Center, bro.
Yeah, we gotta return that plate, dude. That's
well,
a
not plate. No more.
Yeah, but I was saying like the homie Rigo and I, we were pulling up to his to his complex, and we saw these kids that were playing sports, and I'm like, dude, it's freaking crazy how like you don't see that no more. And he's like, yeah, kids are now on their tablets and la 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 bullshit. I'm like, dude, how crazy was it? But the benefit of growing up broke or growing up poor,
bro.
I mean, you say like, what's the benefit of growing up poor? Like,
no, like in a good way.
I know, but it's like.
Well, it's a struggle to start off with.
For sure. Like,
but
no one's like, you know, no one chooses to go that route. But for the people that do choose that route, I feel like they always have more, they're more like, for sure, humble. And they're more like family-based people.
Family-oriented.
Oriented, yeah.
I do agree with that, though.
But like, when you know, when you're growing up and shit, when you're
hold on, like you just can't say like growing up poor, because maybe now growing up poor is a little different than it was back then. We're trying to refer to like, you know, when we're coming up, it was a whole lot. It's a lot different now than now.
Yeah. Like, what do you mean?
Because sure. Like same for now, like, yeah, maybe the family doesn't have like enough money to buy the kid a phone, but the mom or the dad will let their son use their phone. So then, you know, it's not. Were you trying to go based like us growing up without tablets, phones, and right?
Yeah.
And we would play outside.
But okay, what was equivalent to a tablet and a phone back then?
Holy shit, bro.
Like a nice bike, a nice scooter, you know.
Like what did we value? Yeah. Oh, like, okay. Okay. Like, I see.
So,
okay.
So okay. Yeah, and you know, it's totally true because back then we didn't have tablets, but there was Nintendo, there was right. Xbox,
there
all
was
that.
Game Boy,
there was all that bullshit,
PSP, and Game all that Cube, other. You
know?
Yeah.
You know, and so that's equivalent to what kids have now, tablets and stuff like that. Maybe yeah. You know, now it's more accessible and it's easier to get it than back then. You know, but I see a lot of benefit growing up pro, or especially. You know, especially now as an adult, I see it as a benefit.
How?
Because
like what's so benefit? Like,
well, dude, the appreciation of things, that now you understand, like
that, and then the you value the dollar.
You value the dollar, and that you do a lot of things that you value more. You know, now when you get shit, you saw the struggle, and now how you can easily accomplish that, and you see the switch, you see the difference. You know, and you see how. You know, you used to live a life. Now you're living a different life. I mean, hopefully, you've done something in life to live a little bit differently. But that's something that you wouldn't. You know, I would assume you wouldn't value or you wouldn't cherish if you didn't grow up like that. And also the fact of just being like innocent and having fun and going out.
And it was the simple things too.
Yeah, playing with friends, playing with you guys, like going.
Yeah, like we just roll up on the bikes and like. We all had a certain time that we met up with the neighborhood kids. It was never like on the time, on this dot. You know, it was like the sun's about to go down. So we all get our bikes and then just mob the neighborhood and shit like that. And I remember we used to go like far up the streets. Like, you know, that's how I knew our town. Because like when we were young, we just technically rode the whole town in our bikes.
And maybe that's why me and him and I refer to as growing up broke. You know, the beauty of doing all those things, you know, like, for example, when you go to, Mexico,
okay, I see
when
that
you
now,
go to Mexico, yeah. Like they live life differently. It's the way that the kids play in the ground, the outside. And I feel like we did a lot of that. And we did a lot of with like our cousins and our friends. And so like the whole,
and not just that, but like also like hands on, we were very like technical with things. Like we just not read about the things. We also were like.
Experience like hands on,
yeah.
But see, going back to like you're saying, growing up broke. Now thinking about it, it is kind of a perk. Like when we you know growing up, a bicycle for someone is a luxury, right?
Mm-hmm.
But for us, it was an essential because that's how we would get to school. Cool, because yeah. My dad had to take my mom to work. He had dialysis. He had all that going on. So that was our source of transportation.
And then we had one vehicle.
Exactly. So you know my parents relied on the bicycles for us to get to school.
Yeah,
I remember one of the bikes. It was like
the one my grandpa got us. It was like a motorcycle bike kind of.
Yeah, so it was like the regular the molding was like of a motorcycle, but it was fixed on the bike. So
it's like the frame of a bicycle with add-ons of a motorcycle. Yeah, it was crazy.
Do you guys remember putting a soda can in the back of the
tire to sound like a motorcycle? Yeah, fucking wasting tires, bro.
Yeah, it's those crazy little things. Or for example, you know, like you were saying that we depended on our bicycles to get to school as transportation. But every time we would go to school, we wouldn't see like, damn, we got to ride our bikes. No, we would make a game out of it. Mm-hmm. We would make a game
bro,
out of
there's,
it.
Bro, after school, I'll look forward. Like the only thing that would push me through school sometimes, like, yo, I get to ride home. My brother
because it was like
chilling.
Downhill.
Yeah, so you just.
I remember one time I got detention, so I had to stay back for like. I don't know. I think it was like I had to stay back for like 15 to 20 minutes or so.
Sounds about right.
And so that day, my dad was picking us up. But the day before, I told him, I was like, hey, I got detention. He's like, oh, well, you better take your bike. You know, so we had an Astro van. So the bike, I think I took the bike in the van in the morning because the day, like after school, after detention, I was going to ride home and they were going to come home. My dad said, I'm not going to wait for you. So,
you fucked up, bro.
Why do you think I got you the wheel board, bro?
So, dude, I remember this shit so clearly. It was like a movie. All right, so I go into my detention room. I serve my time and I fucking run out. I book it to where the bikes are locked. I freaking book it. I unlock my thing. I don't even think we had locks, huh?
No, we didn't.
Okay. Yeah. And I unlock it and I get on the bike and I'm just mobbing, like freaking mobbing. And I think I got home before you guys. Like my dad, my dad pulled up to the house
And then you're already home?
Oh, yeah. Like, I just barely made it. I was like taking stops. Boy, I was like mobbing it. Mobbing, dude.
Hey, has anybody ever like had it had a bicycle stolen?
Yeah, bro. Shit. I mean, where we used to live wasn't the best neighborhood. I remember it was Dil Chepe's bike and my bike. My bike was
The Mongoose.
It was a Mongoose, huh? But it was like if you compare it to a car, it would be like a lowrider. Yeah. Like it had the spokes, like the similar as like a lowrider. And it was like a candy paint job. It was like lime green. Mm-hmm. They stole my uncle's bike and they stole my bike, bro.
Yeah. That's why I was pissed. They replaced it with some like
fucking shitty ass bike. Bro, he took two in the left, one shitty ass bike with a flat tire.
How do I not remember this shit?
And it's crazy because they know that those bikes were there because, bro, the bikes were behind the house. So
They
opened the gate and they went around the house and they got them. And they left their bike like there. At the house. It was crazy.
Bro, you stole my fucking transportation to school.
Damn.
I know.
Come on, man.
So I feel like an asshole now.
Dude, I know.
What's it called? But a lot of it, I guess it has to be perspective of how you view it now. Because back then, did you view it the same way as now? Nah, right?
No, but I do know that I am going to sound like my dad and my mom when I have kids.
Oh,
back in my days, I used to ride a bike to school.
Straight shit.
You know what I'm saying?
But there's perspective of it because somebody can have a different perspective where like, you know what? Well, no, because of growing up broke, I didn't get to experience this. I didn't get to experience that. My parents didn't buy me this. My parents didn't buy me. Because there's a lot of people that have that perspective. Like, oh, no, you know, because of us growing up broke, we didn't have those other opportunities that other kids had.
Well, we didn't, but probably because we weren't that broke. Because, like, we had the luxury, like you said, to ride bikes from school, and that was our transportation.
Well, no, what I said is, like, having a bike is a luxury. Right. But for us, it wasn't. It was
a necessity.
It was an essential thing we needed.
But,
yeah.
Bro, like, but what about the people that can't even afford a bike?
See, that's the thing, though. When every time, like, I would, like, ride the bike to school or home, I would always be like, look, like, it sucks that you're walking, but, like, I'd rather be on a bike than walking. So that's why I was happy, you know? Like, fuck, at least I'm not fucking walking.
But what if the person walking be like, fuck, I wish I was on a bike, but I can't afford it.
Fuck, bro. Like,
well, I mean...
Sell wristbands, bro. Fuck.
You haven't met Gary V.
You gotta Gary V the shit out of it, bro.
You see the trash can next to you? That little table? Get it, sand it, paint it, put it on OfferUp.
What's a memory that, you know, what's a memory that you have as a child that, you know, you struggled, but now that you cherish it or you see it like, damn, you know, what's up?
I think one of our first accomplishments was, you know, we were shit, bro. I don't even know how we were like, what, 10, 11?
Oh, or is it going to
12? I really don't remember, but we wanted a pocket bike and my parents didn't have the money for it. So they're like, you guys have to work for it. So we set up a yard sale. We set up a yard sale and like within that day, we got the $100.
That's right.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, yeah, we got that pocket bike.
Yeah, we got that pocket bike.
I remember rolling up with those $100.
Bro, we rolled up. I was like, we rolled up. We have $100. We know how much the bike is worth because we asked.
And Juan still trying to help.
Juan's like, them down. I'll give you 75.
All tough, too.
Bro, no.
And then, no, he was funny because it's funny. Up. It's a little ass kid, bro. He's like, I'll give you 75. And then he's like, oh, no, I can't do this. It's too low. He's walking around the bike looking at it like he knows what the fuck he's doing. It all has a scratch here.
He's like, oh, I don't know.
Yeah. I'm like, bro, like, do you even know about bikes? The guy's like, dude, I'm in a bike crew. And he's like, and I'm like, and then he tells me his bike crew. I'm like, never heard of it. Yeah, I mean, I was trying to hustle, dude. Hey, if we would have saved $25, it's $25.
No, but you're always that kid.
Hey, that's funny for gas, bro.
That's like, you would always that kid. And I think that's because like you got it from my grandpa.
Oh, hell yeah, dude.
Oh,
like,
yeah, dude.
The hustle. Since like you were born, my grandparents always had you everywhere. And so like, even when you went to the swamp meets, like, you got that from my grandpa haggling, like, you know, trying to
negotiate. Especially grandma, bro. She hardcore, bro.
My grandma's a hardcore, bro. Like she a boss. That's a real boss right there, bro. It's not like those people that be like lips by by blah, 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 blah. All my boss, bullshit. I mean, no knocking on anybody's business, but my grandma was a boss, bro. She started a fucking, she started a resale from like zero to like $40,000 a month.
It was the first one, like, and the neighborhood that would come to you, like the store would.
My grandma was like,
she had a van. She pulls up, opens the door, and you get to select whatever you wanted. Damn. Everything was in a dust bag.
I remember we used to go with my grandma, my grandparents, to LA every morning to pick up the loads of clothes.
And then stuff like my grandpa would always have eggs for us, right? Like the boiled eggs, and we would always eat that. I remember that.
Dude,
also, I remember when we would take time, like it'll be 1 week you, 1 week, you know, we alternate. But we would take gorditas and we'll sell them.
The cookies?
But the thing is that we wouldn't even sell them, bro. My grandma's like, okay, yeah. Like, she takes her notes down, like, whatever they paid her and all that. And she's like, oh, yeah, is mi neto está vendiendo galletas.
Bro,
we would fucking sell out the crackers like that.
It was because, like, they'll look at us and we were small-ass kid with, like...
No. At first. But then after they tried them, they would sell, like, there's people that would be like, yo, ¿y dónde está el niño de las galletas? Because there's times that we wouldn't go. But, dude... I remember one time, like within 15 minutes, like four houses, I sold all of them.
It's crazy, but like now you look at it and you see that you understand the actual definition. What is it? It's networking. She was literally networking. Like,
it's true.
Like, she's like, oh, I'm going to hook you up with my clients. And they're going to buy from you and boom. Like, it's crazy. And it's crazy that as a little kid, you got to go through these struggles. You learn all that shit, networking. You know, for example, when we had a wristband business, you know,
it was very successful, by the way.
It was very successful.
I had coins coming out my pockets like crazy. Dude. But not just that, when we used to, I think it was the whole aspect of like being able to like, at that time, we didn't know what's a hustle, right? We didn't know what the fuck was to hustle. But for us to like be able to not just like, we weren't with this money, we weren't like bringing food to the table or nothing like that, but it was the fact that so we were so young and yet we were able to make some sort of money. I think that's what we liked. And so because we even started like buying chocolates at the candy man and
we would flip them,
we would be outside so of that, and it got to this point like we even be looking like you know, like we just there for days, and it got to the point where people would just like buy it just to buy it and even want the chocolate. But like it was just that, like we didn't feel bad doing it. We weren't like, oh, we're poor and we need this. We were just like,
we're just trying to make money.
Like,
yeah.
It's crazy. You can make money just by standing here and be like, you want to buy some chocolates? Like,
that is crazy. Now I think about it and look back, we flipped chocolates. We flipped.
We started from wristbands. We used the profits to buy chocolates to sell chocolates.
Damn, dude. And then we did the gorditas.
Gorditas.
And then the yard sales. It's crazy. We've done a lot of selling, and it's not like a freaking selling podcast, but you know, or like you can do anything, freaking like self-improvement podcast. But it's crazy how, like, if you look back at it now, we've always been on that line, on that training. We've been getting trained. We just didn't know it.
That's very true.
And now it comes like naturally to do it.
And to add another one too, I remember when, I think it was that weekend when we did that yard sale, we had all those toys and stuff. I think it was the weekend right before or right after all the leftover toys we had. We put them on a wagon and we went around the neighborhood. And I think it was right before Christmas or something.
And we started giving them out.
We were selling them.
That's right.
Fuck Amazon. Like, fuck Amazon.
We come to you and you.
We're dead ass going to door. That was door to door selling right there.
Bro, like, dead ass. We copied my grandma's business model. I know. We went to the houses.
What 3-day shipping?
On demand, bro. What you want? Toys got you. What you want? You want these? We got it. Nah, dude, it's crazy.
Oh, you want some clothes? I could call some real quick.
I got somebody on the quick. Nah, but it's crazy how all these things, you know, you learned and it humbles you. But then again, it makes you stronger and it makes you tougher as a person because we did take some rejections. But it's crazy because back then, we would take a no and we didn't give a fuck.
I remember this one time. Like, these this couple, they came and then they're like, oh, what does this do? How does it work? This and that.
Yeah.
So we already had like that product, so we know what we're like, how to describe it and how to sell it to them. And then after they're like, okay, no, this is not for me, they'll leave it. And then we would always look at each other, fucking wasting my breath. What the fuck, bro?
Yeah,
dude, keep it up. We're fucking young as shit.
And no, also, like, when we got that no, it wasn't like, oh, it turned us down and we were like, oh, I don't want to go ask the next person. It was like, all right, cool. I'm trying to get the next yes. Like, it was, I'm trying to get a yes, not a no.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, back then, we were like, okay, it's a no. Okay, that's cool. Like, next, you know, and now people are
like if you get a no,
they're scared for a fucking no, dude. You know, a lot of people are scared to like do something because, oh, they're going to say no. They're going to say no. They're going to say no. They're going to reject me. You know, and back then our mindset was like, well, okay, next. You know, and where does your fucking brain stop developing that consciousness of not giving a fuck, you know, of the no, of the rejection, and just keep going on. Yeah. You know, and how do you fucking untrain it, dude?
That's the hard part.
To where, like, where it's like back then, we're like, no, okay, cool. Next, no, okay, cool. You know, and like, it's just crazy how maybe through life we go through so many bad experiences, so many rejections, we get so many feelings, we hear so many people saying, oh, they say no is not good, or don't bug them because they're gonna say no.
I think it has to do a lot with social media. It has to do with a lot of appearances. So if you're not up to the standards and you get shut down, you look like a fool. You get me? And it got to like those points where like people don't try no more, because if they do try, they're going to look like failures.
And if they're trying now, they call them tryhards.
Yeah.
They try.
So maybe,
I mean, like, regardless, people are going to say shit, fucking do it.
And like,
fucking
I think that's one of the things too. Like during our generation, we had no phones. We had no media. It was just us, word of mouth, door to door.
Yeah.
You know, so it wasn't like we were putting it out there like, hey, we're selling toys. And then other kids around the block be like, why buy for them?
You know
that would have put us like, oh shit.
We actually went and like hustled, like door knocking, like, hey, we're selling this, you want anything?
Yeah.
I remember I remember some kid named Austin. So we know how we were the first ones to start actually selling shit at school. Well, this fool wanted one of our products. I think he wanted a mini media. The first fucking MP3 ever to come out.
That shit was like the iPad. The fucking iPod.
Yeah, it's like crazy. You listen to the radio, you can start like three songs if you're lucky, and a couple pictures. You can record the
radio.
Yeah. Like, the headphones came with an antenna.
A dual jack. So you and your homie can listen to the same shit.
You ain't got that option now.
When we were going to field trips, we were the fucking shit.
Yeah, dude. But I remember like this fool wanted to get his own shit. His mama didn't want to give him the money for it, so he begged his mom to buy him snacks and a wagon so he can sell his shit, like chips, snacks, and all that after school, so he can buy our product.
Fuck.
Yeah, dude. And I was like, bro, we instilled that in your head.
Yeah,
bro.
Like, you're welcome. If you're watching it out there and you're successful, you're welcome. If you're not, you're still welcome.
But see, that's another thing that brings me back to, like, not the whole point, like, that we were poor. It got us to that point, and that's in, like, in those situations. But it was also that us, the three of us, the four of us, we were our own friends and we were our own circle.
Yeah.
So if we had other friends, like if it was just two of us, and it would have been like don't come near me and my friends because you're younger type of thing. And
nah, for us, it was a whole different thing.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
yeah,
for the fact that we were all like,
we're very close. So,
and we were our own friends and stuff like that. So we were always into the same thing. And if we wanted to hustle, then the rest of us
hustled,
you know. And for that same reason, I think
I don't know who started selling like the wristbands, but I know I did. I don't know who it was.
I think because we went to school and we had them.
And you're like, would you get them?
Would you get them? And we started giving them out, and then we were just like,
why don't we sell them?
And I think we started like 50 cents the pair or some shit. And
dude, that's honestly, I ain't gonna lie to you guys. Like, that's the greatest feeling I ever had in my life. It's when I still remember that day like it was yesterday. Dude, I opened my backpack because I'm trying to get one for one kid. And I look to the fucking playground, and like everybody has your shit, dude.
I knew we were gonna get in trouble when it was gonna get all this shit was gonna get shut down. When I was in my class and it was recess time. I walk out and already had a line outside my classroom.
Oh, bro,
fucking dude! When I saw that, I was we're gonna get shut down.
Yeah. Okay. If you, look, it's like we were the, for example, like say you're in high school. or college. In high school, we were like that pot dealer that like everybody loved because we had the great pot. In college, we were the people that had the fucking Addy.
See, dude, but nowadays, yeah. Everybody at school, like high school, middle school, they have their own gym bag and they're selling candies. Like for every 10 kids, there's a seller.
Well, yeah, because more people are like interested in the hustle. More people are, it's more exposed. Back then, like, we didn't have that exposure. We didn't have a fucking Gary Vee. We didn't have a Grant Cardone.
Fuck no, bro.
You know,
we just had wristbands we were giving out for free. We just said, fuck that. Yeah, like, make some money.
Yeah. I think, and the only reason why we got our business shut down at school was because
we're taking over the cookies. Yeah. Bro. We're taking over the cookies. It was 25, you get cookies or you get a wristband.
Yeah.
Everybody got wristbands.
Malparido, huh? He was like, we were Pablo Escobar.
I remember the principal called us and he's like, look guys, you guys can't sell them because we're losing money on the cookies and we can't have that.
And we use that money to get books and stuff like this. And we're like, ah,
bullshit. Whatever.
And so I think we started selling them after school, but even then it was just like,
see, yeah, but
if
we would have been more developed, we would have been like, listen, bro, I'll give you 10% of cut.
I
you
know, shush.
Bro. If we knew back then what we know now, bro, shit.
We would have been having people selling.
Fuck yeah, dude!
Chilling. Yeah, dude. Fuck. The potential, look, like, you know, the potential is real, guys. But hey, hopefully you guys enjoyed this podcast. Thank you for tuning in. If you stay all the way to the end, you guys are the true MVP, and you guys are the people that are actually making this happen. Thank you so much from the bottom of our heart. Let us know if you guys like this format where it's just three of us sharing stories. And like we're saying this thing, well, shit, guys, anything's possible. I mean, us three guys growing up in Ontario, California, Nocta Street, shout out to Nocta Street. We were hustling, you know, this and this and that. Just to actually, not even like for ends meet, just to have fun pretty much.
Yes, sir.
But yeah, guys, like, share, subscribe. Make sure to comment down below if you guys had any hustles or
if you ever bought one of our products.
Hell yeah. Y'all true MVPs too.
And if y'all got bad reviews, don't hit us up. Yeah. Never sold you guys shit.
Yeah. Well, let us know if you know how your upbringing was and how you guys grew up, and if you guys, you know, agree with the fact that, you know, sometimes growing up poor or growing up broke, you know, it's a beautiful thing, guys. Thank you again, guys. So we're out in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, boom.
Subscribe!